Okay, good evening. I want to welcome you to our service tonight. And a couple of announcements from the Book Cafe. The MP3 version of the entire convention is available for you to purchase tonight. So if you want all 617 messages, that's not a total exaggeration. There is 52 different messages, plus not counting all the guys that spoke that one morning, which was about 24. So that's available tonight in the Book Cafe. Also, a reminder, tomorrow is an open day here on the campus. That means we're open, doing our day-to-day stuff. And that means there will be a lunch wrap, and then there also will be grace hour here on the campus, and then also seven footsteps in the evening. Okay? All right. As you stand and we get ready to pray, we just want to remember Steve Seymour. He used to work on our tech operations staff. Had a serious boating accident this afternoon and needs a miracle. So if you could stand with me and we'll pray for him and to pray for our service tonight. So Lord, we just lift Steve to you, Faith and his family, Lord. And we just believe you for your work in all of this, Lord, that you would heal and do a great work in this, Lord. Bring glory upon yourself, Lord, a great testimony through this situation. And we ask you to just give wisdom to all of those caring for him, Lord, that you would really do a great work, Lord, in this. And then tonight for our service, that you would bless us, Lord. Lead us, Lord. Refresh us, Lord, by your Spirit. Just pray for our time of worship, our time in the Word, Lord. Just thank you for all of those traveling now, heading home, Lord, that you would protect them, guide them, help them reach their destinations. And thank you, Lord, just so much for the time that we have had together. Amen.
You are all I'm living for. You are King of everything. I want my life to praise you. You are God, you are Lord. You are all I'm living for. You are King of everything. I want my life to praise you.
Open wide here, you saved my life. Here I cry out your name, Jesus.
Jesus.
The name above names. Jesus, our Lord, our Savior. It is only by His mercy that we are saved. Jesus, He's the God of grace and mercy. Thank you, Lord. Bless us tonight. In Jesus' name, amen.
We've been blessed this week by having many different portions. Let's see. We have heard 55 messages this past week and today. 55, you know, amazing messages and portions. And tonight we have three more. The map, we're learning geography as we go along in Greater Grace World Outreach. Isn't that great? So on the map we have India, and at the top to the right a little bit, there's Nepal, this part of the subcontinent here. Let's see, can I write on there or no? All right. Because the color doesn't come out so clear. Okay. So this is the country here. You see that? This is the country of Nepal. And it's very high mountains. Like gradually, and then it goes up very high with the border of China. Mount Everest, everyone knows about that mountain over this direction here. Here's Kathmandu in the center. The first speaker is with the translator, Pastor Narge. Pastor Narge is over here, Pokhara, somewhere. He could put it down there more accurately. And Pastor Narge came here. Well, he met us and has followed the Lord, came here for Bible college, returned to his home country. Pastor Rajan and his story with his wife Indu is written up on one of our blogs. So maybe you can search and find fascinating story about this Hindu family who had made big decisions to follow Christ, found themselves ostracized from the family, homeless, with difficulties and challenges, but trusting Christ. Pastor Carl here in Mumbai had it in his heart to go. The story is long. I'm sure Pastor Walsh and his family lived there for a period. There is a history, and Indians that have gone there. And I'm sorry, Pastor Melvin was one. Maybe he's here tonight. He's been here with us. So I can leave out names, like really. Thanks for taking the offense if I've forgotten you. But to make this introduction short, you know, there was a time in Nepal when you were persecuted for being a Christian, for baptizing someone. You could go to prison for it, for converting. And then it changed, you know. The country took on a more democratic form. And there has been, in the last whatever, I don't know, 10 years or 15 years, this openness and real work of God up in the mountains with people that have come to Christ. Pastor Rajan got on the radio. Pastor Carl met him. He started to listen to tapes, learn English, follow Christ, serve the Lord. God gave a congregation and a mission and a vision. They have a Bible college. They have a building. Pastor John and Diane Post live there. Well, you couldn't have better missionaries. They're just awesome people. And people come from, so the radio is 15 minutes a week, and they get letters, and up in the, you know, I don't know how to describe it to you, but these are mountain people, you know, this is very simple living, and they may have to walk for, a day or more, crossing glacial streams to get to the post office and post a letter to him saying they want to get into the Correspondence Bible College. How many correspondence students are there? 3,000 Correspondence Bible College students. You know, that means they mail and then he has the materials, and they study, they fill out, they do their assignments, and then they may travel to Kathmandu, which means walking through mountain passes, catching a bus, traveling to get to Kathmandu. They may leave home for a couple weeks, come, and just study in his Bible college for a few weeks, and then go back up into the mountains. And they bring the message. And the villages, I mean, some villages, they are against it. And then some faithful, courageous preacher, teacher, believer brings Christ, and whole villages, or 90% of them, very interesting stories about how God is bringing a revival in this country. And how many districts are there, Pastor? 75 different districts, so those are like counties or states, 75 different, and his vision is a greater race church in every state. Now, how many churches are there? 30? 30, 35, Pastor Narge has a few, Pastor Rajan has. So 30, 35 churches in the country of Nepal. Okay, welcome Pastor Rajan. He'll speak in Nepali and Pastor Narge will translate.
Nepali greetings, Jai Masi.
Jai Masi, that's the way we greet each other in Nepal.
Alikati ajai pastor sala le bhannu bhayeko kura lai alikati thapna chahanchu ma.
I just want to add a few things to what Pastor Shah has already said.
Aile hami aile chai 30 wada bhanda badi church haru cha.
There are more than 30 churches that are part of Greater Grace.
Bible College ba ami sanga 35 jana arko naya vidyarthi hununcha.
We have 30 new Bible College students in Kathmandu.
Ani waharu chai ajai tyo remote area tira jadai jane hununcha.
And they from their training they will go to remote places all over Nepal.
Taskarle ami 2 barsha sakisaknu bhayeko cha kei student harle.
Some of the students have already completed 2 years of Bible college. And let's hope these students will complete their training by next year and they will go to these remote places where they came from.
Radio 3,000 Bible college
And as Pastor Shallow already mentioned, through our radio ministry, we have more than 3,000 correspondent Bible college students.
Nepal, America, bhanda 88 guna sano cha.
Nepal is 88 times smaller than the United States.
Tara bhaugolik hisabli, geographically, bhaugolik hisabli chai sayad America ma hami 24 ghanta ma aipugcha bhane tya chai 10 din samma lagna sakcha.
Geographically speaking and logistically speaking, in America you can probably travel from one place to another in 24 days.
24 hours.
But in Nepal, it may take 10 days to go from one end to the other. So in that respect, Nepal is a very big place. So please pray for Nepal.
Pastor Shalor, dhanyabad dina chahanchu yo samay.
I want to thank Pastor Shalor for this time.
Pastor John Post, Diana Post, Nepal ko lagi pathaunu bhayeko cha.
And I want to thank the church for sending Pastor John Post and Diane to Nepal.
Teskarle hamile ajhai badi prabhu ko kaam garna lai sajilo bhayeko cha.
This has helped help the work in Nepal a lot.
Nepal ko kura pachi ma parmeshwar ko bachan tira jaudai chu alikati.
I want to look at the word for a moment. Ephesians chapter 2, verse 4. I will read it in English. But God, who is rich in mercy, for his great love wherewith he loves us. God, who is rich in mercy.
अनि मैले धनीको विषयमा मैले बताउन खोज्दाखेरि
when I want to explain about richness
मेरो विचारमा मैले यो यो अझै पर्याप्त छैन.
I think the word does not do justice to its meaning.
धनी मानिसको चाहिँ यताबाट पनि पैसा आउला यताबाट पनि पैसा आउला हैन यताबाट पनि पैसा आउला सबै ठाउँमा उसको पैसा पैसा हुन्छ.
A rich man in the world may have money in his left pocket, in his right pocket, in his, you know, shirt pocket. He may have money from everywhere.
Parmeshwar chai kripa ma dhani hununcha.
God is rich in mercy.
Wahabata kripa bhaye ke pani aaudaina.
Nothing comes out of him except mercy.
कहिले कहिले हाम्रो सोचाइमा चाहिँ हामीले यहाँ यो पृथ्वीको यो चाहिँ हाम्रो पृथ्वीको कुरा सोचेर हामीले धनीलाई धनलाई चाहिँ हामीले सीमित बनाउन खोज्छौँ.
Sometimes in the world we define riches as material things that we find here. We limit richness.
तर परमेश्वरको वचन चाहिँ जो स्वर्गमा बनिएको हो.
But the word of God, which is from heaven.
अनि त्यो चाहिँ स्वर्ग चाहिँ अब बाउले बताए अनुसार तेस्रो स्वर्ग जहाँ चाहिँ एकदम त्यो चाहिँ इटर्नल त्यो चाहिँ त्यहाँ चाहिँ सबै कुरा नाप्न नसकिने छ.
एन्ड पॉल स्पीक्स अफ द थर्ड हेभन वेयर यु नो द हेभन क्यानट बी मेजर्ड.
त्यो किसिमले हामीले कृपालाई हेर्ने हो भने
एन्ड इफ वी लुक एट मर्सी फ्रम द्याट पर्सपेक्टिभ
सधैँ परमेश्वरले कृपा गर्नुहुन्छ.
That God is rich towards us all the time.
त्यो कृपा हामीलाई दिनुभएको छ.
And this richness he has, this mercy he has given to us.
म एउटा उदाहरण भन्न चाहन्छु यहाँ.
I would like to give an example.
एकजना मानिसले चाहिँ आफू गरिब भएको महसुस गर्यो.
There is a man who feels that he is very poor.
त्यसपछि ऊ कसैसँग पैसा माग्न जान्छ.
And he goes and asks for money from someone.
अनि उसले उसलाई के भन्थ्यो भने ऊ त्यो पर अर्को मानिस छ उसकोमा जाऊ एउटा आँखा बेच्यो भने तिमीलाई 50,000 रुपियाँ दिन्छ.
And the person who he asked money from says to him, you go to another person there, and if you sell your eyes to that person will give you money.
50,000.
Let's say 50,000 rupees.
अनि उसले भने होइन म मेरो आँखा बेच्दिनँ.
And that person, the poor man, says, no, I don't want to sell my eyes. And the person says, well, if you don't want to sell your eye, if you sell your hands, it will be 100,000 rupees. And that poor man says, no, I don't want to sell my hands. This body is worth millions of dollars. They said, I don't want to sell my body. And that person says to the poor man, well, if your body is worth millions of dollars, why are you begging? Why are you asking for money? You are in fact rich. And our God, who is rich in mercy, He has given us grace. He has loved us.
And
we have to apply this truth in our life in a practical way. We have received eternal life. And our sins have been forgiven. It's been paid for. And He has given us mercy. I want to share one incident in our church. One Bible college student.
He stole
a video camera
and
three laptop computers and other very expensive electronic items he stole, and he left the Bible college. And during that time, I was in another place. And I got a call from the Bible college. And the staff in the Bible college said, this student has stolen these items and he has run away. And I told that staff member, and I said to the staff, you know what, we shouldn't care for the video camera, the laptop, or all the items he has stolen. What we should care for, who we should care for, is that Bible college student.
I'm like,
we need him back. And there was an attempt to find the boy. There was discussion about whether to go to the police or not. And I told him, no, don't go to the police. God has loved us. He has given us mercy. And one time we were like that boy. But he still loved us. After 15 days, through Facebook, he left a message for me. I didn't scold him. I didn't mention anything about what he had done. I just told him one thing. His name is Dawa.
Dawa, timi malai chahiyeko
cha. I need you, Dawa. Please come back.
Timi aao.
You can please return back to the college. Forget about what happened. Please come back to the college. And I sent this message repeatedly 4 or 5 times.
And
finally he wrote a reply. And then I told him, please come and meet me.
अनि भेट्ने कुरा त गर्यो तर मसँग होइन अरूसँग भेट्ने कुरा गर्यो
बट ही सेड यस आई विल मीट यू बट ही फेल्ट शेमफुल सो ही डिडन्ट वान्ट टु मीट मी सो ही मेट विथ समबडी एल्स
अनि अर्को मान्छेले चाहिँ मैले भने उसलाई जसरी पनि चाहिँ मकान लिएर आऊ
एन्ड आई टोल्ड द्याट पर्सन हु मेट हिम प्लीज ब्रिङ हिम टु मी
जब ऊ मकमा आयो
एन्ड वान्स ही केम ब्याक
मैले उसलाई एउटै कुरा भने
एन्ड आई टोल्ड हिम वान थिङ
परमेश्वरले तिमीलाई प्रेम गर्नुहुन्छ
गड लभ्स यु
तिमी चाहिएको छ हामीलाई
यु आर निडेड हियर
त्यसपछि उसले सबै चोरेको कुरा फिर्ता लिएर आयो
एन्ड देन ही अल्सो रिटर्न्ड ऑल द आइटम्स ही हैड स्टोलन
तर हाम्रो पास्टर जोन पोस्टको एउटा ल्यापटप चाहिँ लिएर आएन
बट पास्टर जोन पोस्ट ल्यापटप इज मिसिङ
त्यसै परमेश्वरको जब हामीले उहाँको कृपा हामीसँग प्राप्त गर्छौँ
वन्स वी रिसिभ गड्स मर्सी
हामी अरूलाई कृपा गर्छौँ
And we also are merciful to others.
Pastor Shala le aaja agape love ko bare ma bataudai hununthyo.
Pastor Shala taught us earlier about agape love.
Sachai hami teslai hamro jivan ma practically garnu parcha jasto
ma lagcha. We should apply this practically in our lives.
Ra hamile sachai nai yo conference bhari dherai kura haru sikyau.
In this conference we have learned a lot of things.
Jo Yakub 3 adhyay ma
James chapter 3
se swarga bada aune buddhi ko kura tya garieko thiyo
we heard about the wisdom that comes from heaven
tya 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 hamle heru bhane tyo chai pavitra huncha
we can see that it's a holy pure wisdom
milanshar huncha
and it is a wisdom that brings people together
komal chha
and it's very tender
मनाउँदा मानिहाल्ने छ दया छ
एन्ड देयर इज अ कम्प्यासन
असल असल फलले भरिएको हुन्छ असल असल फलले भरिएको हुन्छ
एन्ड इट्स फुल अफ गुड फ्रुट्स
साच्चै नै क्रिस्चियन जीवन मलाई त्यही लाग्छ
एन्ड आई बिलिभ आवर क्रिस्चियन लाइफ इज लाइक द्याट
प्रभुले हामीलाई त्यसैको लागि बनाउनु भएको
हो एन्ड गड हेज क्रिएटेड अस फर दिस
त्यसैको लागि उहाँले क्रुसमा हाम्रो हामीलाई रग उहाँको रगत बगाएर किन्नुभएको
फर द्याट भेरी रिजन ही हेज अन द क्रस बोट अस विथ हिज ओन ब्लड
मैले एउटा किताब वाचमेन नीको पढेको
थिएँ आई हेभ रेड वान बुक बाई वाचमेन नी
उहाँले चाहिँ एफिसीको पुस्तकमा कमेन्ट गर्नुभएको थियो
And he had made some comments in this book.
उहाँले तीनटा एफिसीको पुस्तकलाई तीन भागमा भन्नुभयो
He divided this book into three parts. In chapter 1 to chapter 3, it talks about sitting.
And
then chapter 3, verse 6, and then chapter 6, verse 10, it talks about walking. And it tells you how to walk. We have to be very careful how we walk.
Chako 10 dekhi chai antim samma.
And from chapter 6 to verse 10, at the end of the book,
timi khada ho.
It tells you to stand.
Parmeshwar ko kripa hami sang cha.
And God's mercy is with us.
Waha kripa ma dhani hununcha.
And he is rich in mercy.
हामी बाइबलमा यी कुरा थुप्रै ठाउँमा पाउँछौँ
दिस ट्रुथ वी फाइन्ड मेनी प्लेसेस इन द बाइबल
मैले एउटै कुरा अहिले भन्न खोजेको कुरा छ एउटै कुरा छ
एन्ड वान थिङ आई वान्ट टु से टुडे इज
उहाँ कृपामा धनी हुनुहुन्छ
दैट ही इज रिच इन मर्सी
उहाँको कृपालाई हामी खुम्चाउन सक्दैनौँ खुम्चाउन
वी क्यानट रिस्ट्रिक्ट हिज मर्सी
उहाँले हामीलाई प्रेम गर्नुभएको छ
ही हेज लव्ड अस
नेपालको लागि प्रार्थना गर्नुहोस्
सो प्लिज प्रे फर नेपाल
75 जिल्लामा हामीले प्रभु गरेर चर्च स्थापना गर्न सकौँ
लेट्स प्रे वी क्यान प्लान्ट 75 चर्चेस इन अल द 75 डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स
प्रार्थना गर्नुहोस् रेडियो मिनिस्ट्रीको लागि
प्लिज प्रे फर द रेडियो मिनिस्ट्री
हामी रेडियो मिनिस्ट्रीबाट एउटै कुरा प्रचार गर्छौँ
एन्ड वी प्रिच वान थिङ फ्रम द रेडियो मिनिस्ट्री
यीशु किन आउनुभयो
एन्ड वी प्रिच वाइ जिसस केम What did he do? What do I need to believe in Christ? So please pray for this radio ministry. And finally, I would like to say, come and visit us. And encourage us by visiting us.
Amen.
Amen.
Okay, let's say a prayer for the offering. Well, first, let's welcome visitors. If you're here for the first time, would you lift your hand? If this is your first time in one of our services, just raise your hand. We'll bring you right there. Thank you. Thank you for being with us. And a lot of information in the packet about us, and then also people at the Welcome Center can answer questions tomorrow night. We do have a meeting, Footsteps meeting, 7 Footsteps at 7 o'clock. You're welcome to be a part of that. So just great. This is a chance for us to worship by giving what God has freely given to us, and we freely give back to him. So let's just pray for that. Lord, we thank you for this time to give, that you have put it in our hearts, that you have added to us, you have provided for us, you have equipped us. We thank you for our ministry and the things that you have put into our hands, Lord. As stewards, Lord, we use these things for your glory, to share your message, Lord. We just thank you for this time in the service, Lord, when we can worship you in this way. Lord, we just ask you to bless this time, bless this offering, Lord, bless these tithes, Lord. We just thank you for their for all that they're used for, to bring the message to places like Nepal and around the world, places we have heard from all week. In your name, amen.
Standing here in your presence, in a grace so relentless, I am one by perfect love, wrapped within the arms of heaven, in a peace that lasts forever, sinking deep in mercy sea. I'm one. Drawing close, stirred by grace and all. breathe you in, I lean into your love. Oh, your love. Your love so deep is washing.
Okay, our thanks, Pastor. I forgot to mention Pastor Rajan and Indu's son, Hiraj, is here in Bible College, which is a great blessing for us and for the family. All right, let's see. Pastor Anil is going to... We need a microphone for him and a guitar, and he'll minister to us with us before he preaches. He'll just lead us in a worship song. So he's going to come in a minute, and then the band could jump in if you want to. I think so. You welcome the band, right? Yeah. If you got any musical talent, you can jump in. Okay, so somewhere is Goa. I don't know where he was pastoring in Goa here. He's with Pastor Brian here in Bangalore. He has a family. He just loves the Lord. He's a worshiper. So welcome, Pastor Anil.
Okay, good evening, everyone. This is an impromptu song, so please excuse the mistakes. Okay, can we have One Thing Remains on screen? The song, Your Love Never Fails, Never Gives Up, It Never Runs Out on Me. Let's all stand, come on. Thank you. higher than the mountains that I face, stronger than the power of the quake, constant through the trial and the chain. One thing remains. Let's sing, come on. One thing remains. Your love never fails, never gives up, and never runs out on me. Your love never fails, never gives up, and never runs out on me. Your love never fails, never gives up, and never runs out on me. Your heart. On and on and on and on it goes, and it overwhelms and satisfies my soul, and I never have to build to be afraid. One thing remains, yes Lord, one thing. Your love never fails and never gives up and never runs out on me. Your love never fails and never gives up and never runs out on me. Your love. And on it goes, come on. And on and on and on and on it goes. And it overwhelms and satisfies my soul. I never have to ever be afraid. One thing remains. One thing remains. Okay, I want to hear you. Your love never fails, never gives up, and never runs out on me. Your love never fails, and never gives up. It never runs out on me. Your love never fails, never gives up. It never runs out on me. Your love. In death, in life, I'm confident, covered by the power of your great love. My debt is paid. One last time. Your love never fails, never gives up, and never runs out on me. Your love never fails, never gives up, it never runs out on me. Your love never fails, never gives up, it never runs out on me. Your love.
Okay, good evening, everyone. It's great to worship the Lord with you. I think of Revelations 5 and verse 9, where it says that, you know, you have taken a people out of every tribe and every tongue and every nation. And when I come here, that is the experience, just to see all of you, that we are one body. We are the Lord's church. Amen? And so greetings from Bangalore. Can I have a smile starting from that side? Yeah, that's good. Okay, 1 Corinthians chapter 1 and verse 18. It says here, for the message of the cross is foolishness to those who are perishing, but to us who are being saved, it is the power of God. Let's pray. Father, we thank you, Lord, that your love never fails, never gives up on us, Lord. Speak to us today. In Jesus' name, amen. It was a great week at the convention, listening to a lot of messages, a lot of different men of God. And, you know, there are many things which came to my mind and to my heart. And the first thing which came to my heart is that Jesus is the source. Jesus is the source of salvation. And, you know, Pastor Brian Coelho made this statement in Bangalore, and it was very beautiful. He said that, you know, all other religions are working their whole life, if they believe in a God, to get into heaven or to get into a better afterlife experience. But for us, the beginning point is the gospel. The beginning point is what God has done for us, God in his great love, that when we were sinners, when we were without strength, we were ungodly, and when we were enemies, in Romans chapter 5, 5 to 8, that Christ died for us. And he paid for it all, once and for all. The past, the present, the future. Not for each one of us only, but for the whole world. In 1 John chapter 4 and verse 10. And isn't that beautiful? That is the great love of God for us. Right? And like, you take a tract. In India, you can, our tracts are maybe 5 cents. Right? And you give it to somebody and you have a 1 minute conversation or a 3 minute conversation. And if that person believes, guess what? And he makes that decision, he's saved for eternity. Isn't that beautiful? When you and I, we believed, our one decision, it saved us for eternity. And guess what? There is no undo button with God. You know, if you say, okay, I want to undo it, God can never undo it because of his great love for us. He's paid for it once and for all. Isn't that? Can you imagine that? The world will say, this little piece of paper, you know, this little piece of paper, you're saying, just believe and I have it? Yes. It's the foolishness of preaching. Amen? It's the foolishness of... It doesn't mean that it's worthless, because the Bible says that it took the precious blood of Jesus in 1 Peter 1, 18 and 19. Only that can buy our redemption. Only that can pay for our sins. So Christ is the source. And guess what? Our beginning point started with entry. We are not waiting to enter into heaven. We are already in heaven. Isn't that great? Right? The day you became born again, you were in. The whole world is working to get in. We are already in. Isn't that beautiful? By pure grace. The second point is, Christ is our supply. Christ is our supply. In the book of Exodus chapter 16, God gave them manna in the wilderness. And it's very interesting. It's very interesting that God didn't give it like one whole year's food. He didn't give it like for a whole month. He said, every day you got to come out. I will put it down. You got to gather it. 6 days. On the sixth day, you take it for 2 days. And in Exodus 16:35, the Bible says that the manna fell for 40 years until they reached the promised land. Isn't that beautiful? Which means God's supply is inexhaustible. There can be recession, there can be economic problems, there can be a money crunch, but God will never run out, right? His love will never run out. His mercy, his grace, his favor on our lives can never, ever run out. Isn't that beautiful? But sometimes we make the mistake in Jeremiah 2:13. We build for ourselves our own cisterns when we want to live in the me. This is what I want. This is what I want to do. We live in the me. The Bible says in Jeremiah 2:13, you know, my people have committed two evils. They have forsaken me, the fountain of living waters. And they are hewed out cisterns for them. Broken cisterns which can hold no water. Right? Today is a beautiful day. Tomorrow morning when we get up, His mercies are new every morning. And we can receive from Him. And God is our supply. On a daily basis, simple faith, we receive from Him. And in our third point, and that is which God really showed me this conference, which we know theologically, but you know sometimes we hear it afresh, is that the Lord Jesus Christ is our satisfaction. You know, I'm a music lover. There was the Rolling Stones a long time back. They sang this song, I can get no satisfaction. And I try, you know. And what they were saying was true. What they were saying was true because they were trying different things. Music, alcohol, drugs, immorality, different things. But they couldn't be satisfied. Because what they learned through experience, we can learn today through instruction. Where God says, I am the bread of life. He who comes to me will never hunger, and he who believes in me shall never thirst. And Jesus is our satisfaction. And it is not in a material thing, it is not in a relationship, it is also not in successful ministry. And praise God if he uses me successfully, it is not in successful ministry. It is in him and him alone. Amen? And it doesn't stop there, you know. The whole world is thinking, oh, there are perilous times. What's going to happen? The end times. But you know what the Bible says for us? This is what the Bible says for us. That the Lord is coming back for us. In 1 Corinthians chapter 11. And in Luke 12 verse 40, the Bible says, watch, be careful, because he's coming at a time which you don't expect. Right? The greatest surprise in our lives will be when the Lord comes and says, it's time to go. Oh, Lord, 2 minutes, 5 minutes, no. Look at my eyes. Shk. We're gone. Isn't that beautiful? So in closing today, this is the wisdom of the Bible. We have one God in 1 Corinthians 8, 3 and 4. In India, in Hinduism, you can have a million gods. You can make anything God. We have one God, right? We have one faith. In Ephesians 4, we have one book. In John chapter 21 and verse 35, you know, it's not like Google this and Google that, millions of pages. It's what? One book. Because if everything was written about Jesus, the books of the world could not contain it. God has given it to us in one book, which we can carry in our hands and which we can read, right? And all the knowledge of the world cannot equal it. Because its wisdom is in the book and its simple faith. And in closing today, this is what I want to say to us, to each one of us. God loves us. Even if you don't think that he loves you, he loves you. He has a plan for your life and my life. In Psalm 139 verse 16, all our days are written in his book. Amen? And he will do exactly what he thinks is best for us. Because he is our loving father and he cares for us. Amen.
I just enjoy this so much. It's just awesome. Thank you. Thank you. Wow, what a joy. How many want to go to India? You want to go to India on a mission trip? How about for 1 week? You want to go to India? I'm going to go. Come with me. Let's go. Let's go together. We'll rent an airplane. Why not? You know, a little airplane. You know, 2 weeks later. Let's go to India in Nepal. What about it? What about it? Walk in up there and share the message. Pastor Brian Lange went up there into the mountains with a motorcycle. And they did, you know, wow, what exotic, like far removed, precious people. In India, you know, it's, you gotta go to India if you can. I have this sort of thing, if you live on planet Earth and you've never been to India, then you don't know what it is to be on planet Earth. Okay, so I, you know, okay. All right, so you want to do the seventh inning stretch? Want to stand for just a second? The next speaker is going to come up. Second thought, forget it. Sit down. You got a bad attitude. Okay, so, okay, we're going to go right at the next speaker. Okay, so this is Pastor Kende from Hungary. Yes. Yes, it has happened. Yes, he actually is here. If you are Hungarian, would you stand up, please, if you are a Hungarian here with us? Okay, let's see. Ah, yes, from Kaposvar. And then if, you can sit down over there. That's okay, I'm not sure. Go over there. All right, so we got the Hungarians here, Hungarians stand. If you have lived in Hungary, would you stand up? Wow, look at, they've lived in Hungary. How many of us love Hungary, huh? Yes, we love it. Wow, the Lord is good to us. Then you've been in a Eurocon in Hungary. You've been there. Did you already stand? Okay. In any case, we're familiar with the con. Oh, okay, here we go. Wow, for some reason, they're all over on this side. Now, I want to say a couple of things about him. He's called, he's equipped, he is dedicated, he and his wife, Adele, they took over, he took over the big responsibility, a lot of responsibility in ministry, and it's so good to have him here and to encourage him, love him, hear from him, and pray for him. He's right there, you know, in the work, and this is a real precious work of God, and we have a lot of respect for what God has done and what he is doing there in that important part of the world. So we love you, Pastor. Come and share with us.
Okay, so hi from the exotic jungles of Hungary. there must have been a historic moment, right, that something from the Rolling Stones was quoted in a positive light in our ministry. I thought that was really an amazing moment. I just like, wow, never thought that would happen. Okay, I thought I was going to give an intro. That's what Jen's email said to me. But here I am doing a, I'm supposed to sing. Well, that would be, yeah, you don't want that, no. Yeah, so just to make it meaningful, didn't we have a great week? Are you like, wow, like that was awesome, really. And I don't want to say amazing because I think we use that word so much, too much. But useful, right? I mean, just think about it. If Hebrews 1:3 is true, if the word of God keeps the universe together, if Psalm 119:130 is true, that the entrance of his word gives light, then the conference was awesome because we had so much of the word, right? If Romans 1:12 is true, if we have comfort in the fellowship of the brethren, just look around a little bit. If we have comfort among us, if Romans 1:11 is true, if the messenger imparts a spiritual gift, then the conference really has been awesome because we had so much of the saints, ministry, all these things. Conferences are useful. I mean, if there's anyone here who hasn't been, don't condemn yourself, but don't miss another one. While I'm at it, actually, come to Eurocon, God willing. Unless the rapture happens, then you're exempt. But other than that, come in March and be with us in Budapest. That would be really awesome to have you. So I just thought back about the. I remember the first time I was asked to share here, and the burden of the thought that I have to share in front of so many people who have walked with the Lord for so much longer than I, and whose faith has really been an inspiration, an encouragement, and a direction to me. And I remember that little voice inside saying, "Okay, it's time to dazzle them. You know, just get out the fanciest message that you preach this year, and just go safe and do it. Show them what a great preacher you are." You know, I remember this. My pastor taught me this idea to me that God has a message for the hour. That God has a thought for our hearts for that season that we are going through, and on having that temptation to dazzle. I just want you to remember that. Okay, to dazzle. I just thought of this. If God has the smallest thought, if that is so much more important, that's so much more powerful than anything, and the most dazzling presentation I could do for you, you know. And so, Lord, what is your word for this hour? Lord, what is your thought for us? What is your desire for us? What is your heart for your people? And Lord, what do you have for us? I mean, the simplest word from you, Lord, it is so much more powerful. It's so much far beyond our most beautiful, eloquent words, our well-chiseled presentation and well-polished, you know, and all that we could do. The most dusty, the most down-to-earth thought from the Lord, it carries so much more weight than anything we could do, I could do, obviously. And that's what we have learned to look for. I was with this sister, Zsuzsa Timar, shortly before her death, a few months ago. She got hurt somehow in the ministry a few years ago, like 5 years ago maybe, and she hasn't come since then. And she was pretty angry, I think, for a while, and out there, she was out there and alone. And then she felt something wrong about her, I think, half a year, 9 months ago, and she went to the doctor, and the first diagnosis was final stage cancer. That was the first thing she found out. No cure, no way to prolong life. It's just over. And life fell apart, and she was financially unable to stay afloat, and we found out, and church being what the church is, we chipped in and collected money for her, and I went to her, I brought the money to help her out, and to see her and just to be with her. And as I sat next to her bed, she's really wrecked by cancer. She was a few days before her passing, she was slightly high on morphine, and we had a little conversation, and I thought, wow, I really ought to say something profound now. Like, I'm a pastor at the bedside of someone who, you know, is going on, but actually it ended up being so that I was just sitting there. We were exchanging simple words. We were simply loving one another. We were simply loving the Lord. And there was forgiveness, and there was joy and brokenness, and it was very simple. And then before passing, her testimony was a few days later, she said, "After I got sick, I thought I was alone. It turned out the Lord, the church, was with me even when I didn't expect it." And she didn't need anything, you know. She didn't need the dazzling. She needed just simply the heart of God. And I just want to say, real simple, not hoping to bedazzle any of you, just simply hoping to share the heart of God for us, for you. You know, when you're so sure that you're alone and no one is with you, God is with you. You know, don't ever believe the lie. When you think there isn't one there is a place for you in the church. The day may come when you will think there is no place for you in the church. There is a place for you in the church, in his church, of course. There is. Even when you think that you're so insignificant, you know, it's true that God has an eternal plan in motion and you are in the center of it. You are so important. When your faith is so negligible, you know, you cannot even, you know, not a microscope you think could spot it. You know, God is right there to help you with your unbelief. And, you know, when I'm so evidently broken and unable, then God is ready to use me. When we are insufficient in ourselves, together as a body, we can do amazing, amazing things. And, you know, that's so awesome. I just thought to read in closing this verse. This is Deuteronomy 33:27, really simple. It says, the eternal God is a dwelling place, and underneath are the everlasting arms. And he casts out the enemy from before you and says, destroy. And I thought this is like such an amazing verse for us. I mean, it really is. In a way, you could. It is kind of a life, like a life-defining verse, right? It says the eternal God is a dwelling place. I mean, you know, we know of gods that are, you know, that require sacrifice. We know of gods that are angry. We know of gods that live on Mount Olympus or something. You know, they. But have you ever heard of a God who is a dwelling place? Have you ever heard of a God who is a home? Have you ever heard of a God with whom, in whom we belong, right? Have we ever heard that? It's amazing. No wonder the previous verse says, there is no one like the God of Israel. That's because really, truly, there is no one like that, that our God is our home. That's amazing. We are in him, and in him we are at home. In him we are at peace. In him we are at rest. In him. That's where we belong, and that's awesome. Then it says, underneath are his everlasting arms, and that just makes it so personal. It is the picture of, I don't know, a father or a mother catching the kid, right, when they fall, and that's so awesome for us. It is so personal that God is right there when I fall. He is right there to catch me. It's so beautiful. And then in closing, that verse says, he casts out the enemy from before you and says, destroy. And that is about our responsibility, our part in life, our place, right? That God has done this. This is the beauty of the finished work, right? Colossians 2:15, he has conquered. He has done it. He has finished it. It is done. The enemy is cast out. The enemy has no stronghold to hide in. The enemy has no place. It is done. Satan has been shown for what he is, a murderer, a liar, a fool, and weak. And that's the work of God for us. And then he says, he's there in front of you, you see him, destroy. Because Jesus came into this world in 1 John 3:2 to destroy the works of the devil, right? That's why he came. And we read a little later in 1 John 4:17 that as he is in this, so are we. We are in that place. And we just walk in this. We just live in this victory. And this is our call. Our God, he is our home. He keeps us when we fall. And we are marching in this victory. And this is an awesome, awesome life we have. Amen. Yes. Let's just bow our head for prayer for a moment. And if you are here today and you don't know Jesus, I would like to offer you this opportunity. You could make the decision even today to trust in him. Some people believe that they don't have faith. It's not true. We all have faith. We all trust so many things in life. We trust money, we trust people, we trust family, connections, position. Today, this is your opportunity to trust the God to whom there is no comparable, the God who is a home, who can be a home for you. make a decision today for Jesus, believe in him in your heart, just address him right now from your heart to him. Say to him in simplicity, say to him, Jesus, I need you. Jesus, I want you in my life. I need a God who is a home for me. Jesus, I want to know you. Come into my life. Save me. Give me a new start, a new life. Jesus, I believe in you. If you made that decision for the first time, then please, as every head is bowed, just raise your hand for a moment so the ushers could give you some material that would help you start in the path with Jesus. Just raise your hand and you can put it down again. Is there anyone here today? All right. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for these messages, the joy, the certainty, the assurance, the vision, the hope, your presence. We just thank you, Lord. We worship you, Lord. You're an awesome God. If you would stand with me for a moment and let's just raise our hands. Lord, we are here before you. We trust you. It's amazing to know you. You are our God. You never leave us. You never forsake us. You have gained the victory for us. Lord Jesus, we trust you. We know you. This is awesome. Father, bless us as we go. Father, bless us as we go in our everyday lives. And Lord, we want to praise you. We want to walk with you. Be with us. Cover us. Heal us. Minister to us. Yes, Lord. Dismiss us with your blessing in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you.
Christ is my reward and all of my devotion. Now there's nothing in this world that could ever satisfy. Through every trial, my soul will sing. No turning back, I've been set free. Christ is enough for me. Christ is enough for me. Everything I need is in you. Everything I need. Christ is decided to follow Jesus. No turning back, no turning back. I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back, no turning back. The cross before me, the world behind me. No turning back, no turning back. The cross before me, the world behind me. No turning back, no turning back.
Christ is enough.
Christ is enough for me. Christ is enough for me. Everything I everything I need. I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back, no turning back. I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back, no turning.
All right, just give a hand to the, well, they're not all here, but the musicians. Amazing week, right? They did 47 songs, close to it, anyway. So, all right, so it's awesome. And how many remember I have decided to follow Jesus when it was a country song? Oh, yeah, some night we'll have to just do that, you know. There's other verses to that song beside that, you know. Anyway, there'll be a wrap in about 20 minutes. Some booths are still open serving food, and I think there's still, you know, they're open there. You can, in the inside booths, the other ones have gone, you know. Like the rapture, Scotty's crew tore them down, and they're gone. And give, Scotty Dubay and his crew a great hand. And you know, security does 24/7 beginning conference, so just give security a hand watching over us. And right now, because I'm seeing crying kids in the nursery, we're going to close. But the children's workers and all that, we're just grateful for all that they did, right? Parents and everything. So it was a great week, and nurses, all that. I forgot somebody, I'm sure, but we're just so thankful for everyone that helped this week be what it was. And we'll do it again, right? God willing.